CNBC-TV18 Weekender, only on CNBC-TV18.
Hello and welcome to the Weekender. I'm Manisha Gupta. Well, the Indian dairy sector is nearly 6.5 lakh crores, and out of that, only 28% is organized. We are at the Parag Milk Foods today, and this is a place where they produce 60 tons of cheese, 20 lakh liters of milk. Joining us on the show today is Mr. Devendra Shah, who's chairman, Parag Milk Foods Limited. Let's go meet him. Mr. Shah, hi. Thank you so much for having us at your farms here. Yeah. It is an absolute pleasure to be here. Mr. Shah, let's start with you first, though. What led you into the dairy profession? Was it running in the family or was it your own initiative?
I started my own initiative. Because before that, my father's grandfather, they are good relation with the farmer and they do all business with the farmer relation.
Okay.
When I started my career, I start with the cattle feed. Trade sale to this farmer and cooperative basically.
Okay.
Before the 1992. And thanks to in our country Dr. Kurian, because he take the white milk revolution.
Right.
Yeah. From 80 to 85. And farmer are take such a really very positively. They increase their milk production. But before 1992, this business is monopolized by cooperatives.
That's right.
And semi-government.
Right.
And they are not ready to cope up all milk of the farmers. They give the milk holidays, twice a day, thrice a day. Then farmers are in trouble and little bit my new business, cattle feed business, I look like it's in a problem, issue.
So is that is what led to you starting your own dairy farm like this?
Then I started from the day one. 20,000 liter with a Govardhan brand. Yeah, from.
So you started right in this area here.
Yeah.
How much land and how much cows did you start it with?
Okay. Initially, I took put the processing plant along with the Govardhan brand. I introduced the liquid milk, fresh milk into the nearest Pune and Mumbai metro.
Okay.
Yeah. Next 1.5 year, 2 years, I continuously. From 20,000 to I reach up to 3 lakhs liter milk per day sell into this market. Farmers are so happy because they come out from the milk holidays, they increase their milk production. And I'm so also happy. But there is only milk sell to this in fresh milk. There is a saturation.
Right.
And from 97 to 2002, I convert all this milk production into the skim milk powder and basically ghee. From 97 to 2004, I am the highest skim milk powder exporter from the country itself. But in 2002, 2004, there's a little bit shortage for 3 months, 4 months.
That's right. That wasn't a very good period for the dairy, actually.
Yeah.
But how is it now? How is the situation now? Because even in this budget, we heard so much being said about agriculture and the allies, from animal husbandry to dairy, etc. What is your sense on where we stand as a country when you look at dairy as an industry?
India is the largest milk producer in the world.
Right.
But we consume itself in the domestic market. 99%, 98% our milk sale into the Indian market, all players. 2% there is a possibility for the exports.
Right.
Yeah. And there is a demand continuously growing because country is growing very fastly.
Yeah.
And country needs the good agriculture support and this type of the dairy support. And this time this budget gives a good initiative for the next 2, 3, 4 years. And we take very positively.
So where does this farm stand right now? How much of liters of milk and how many cows do you have right here?
We have around 3,200 cows now around at the farm, from baby cow to all milking cow.
Right.
I have very proud because I have one of the best cow. She Aishwarya, we call Aishwarya. She produces 54 liter milk per day. Karina, I call, she produces 48 liter milk per day.
So how long is the life for these cows? How long will these cows give you that milk on a daily basis?
Cow is giving allow 8 times to 9 times is milking.
Okay.
It's around 12 years to 15
12
years.
12 to 15 years. Tell more about yourself now. You started only with milk, as you said. You got into skim milk then. You have been exporting as well. And you also have gotten yourself into other premium products when it comes to dairy. What is the category which is doing the best right now?
Yeah, at the farm, we are doing pride of cow. Such an Indian in
that's market. A very premium product, by the way, and it's doing quite well.
Very quite well.
Yes.
Even we service into the only two metros, Pune and Mumbai.
Yeah. Okay.
But entire country looking this type of the model, how it's a success. And Go Cheese, what we take the initiative. Before 2009, in Indian market, cheese means just cheese, processed
cubes
cheese.
And cheese slices.
And that's it.
Yeah.
And when we introduce the cheese for the mozzarella, cheese for the taco, cheese for the pizza, cheese for the nachos, cheese with the round wedges, cheese like in the glass bottle.
Flavored cheese as
well. The flavored cheese, yeah. Cheese with the chutney. Recently we launched cheese slice with the chutney. This type of so many innovative products we introduce into the Go brand. Even some gourmet cheese we introduce. The cheddar cheese, Montevideo Jack. This type of the people like this. They appreciate our all innovative cheese. And we take the 33% market share within the 5 years period. And this category is a continuous growing and throughout the world and in the country itself. Cheese is really a superfood. Recently we launched the proteins. Yeah, the Indian first protein plant we introduced with the Avatar sports nutrition brand. Before that, this entire country, the sports nutrition, we import, we depend on an imported market and we are not sure. This powder is how is the genuinity, veg, non-veg, because the whey is a byproduct of the cheese.
That's right.
Yeah, in Indian only we have norms to make it cheese with a vegetarian source only.
Right, right.
But internationally they doesn't have any norms to manufacture the cheese. And you know the Indians are 60% vegetarian, 80% people are protein deficiency. For the mass people, we are coming with a mass protein very soon with a Go protein.
So if we put just all the categories that you just mentioned, which is the most flying there? Where do you see the maximum sales happening? Is it the milk, which I am assuming would be the case, but your ghee has done quite well. The paneer, the cottage cheese is doing quite well, and the quality is really good. I just, complimented you on that.
Yeah, thank you for that.
So what is really doing very, very well when you look at all the categories?
There is such an internal competition is there.
I'm sure.
Govardhan ghee is the flagship product.
Okay.
Yeah, in our total portfolio is around 22 to 23%. The cheese is the same, like 22%. And when we introduced in the last 3 months before, with the Avatar brand, people really, in a very short period, people well accept, giving the well numbers.
So tell me also, how much time do you spend here? Because there is this particular smell around the cows. how long are you here? How much time do you spend here normally?
Yeah, when I'm here, almost my morning jogging time I spend here. Morning I reach here around 6:30 and up to 9:30, 3 hours. I doesn't want to leave from here.
And you have named your cows Karishma, Karina, etc. What really leads to that?
It's a celebrity name. It's a celebrity for me.
You want to make your cows feel like celebrities, is it?
Celebrity, yeah.
All right. Let's also talk about the market then. You mentioned earlier during when we were talking on how there has been only corporate culture before dairy actually is how it was prevalent in Indian markets. With so many new entrants now, what is the kind of market share or competition that the dairy industry as of now faces?
Dairy industry story just started.
Okay.
Yeah, just started, I say. If you call any pan-India, there is no player, only serious player. Yeah, one, two or three players is there to serious play. But now all international world players want to come in India.
Yeah, so that really is my next point. You know, it's not just the domestic market, but MNCs also want to make an entry here.
Yeah.
So how is the market looking to you?
Without entry, India, they can't survive.
Yeah.
Yeah, India is a so big population, highest growing population, young population, and Indian loves dairy. Indian loves dairy.
I can tell you, I love dairy products.
Yeah,
so
yeah. If you go in Punjab, you go in Haryana, if you go in Gujarat, everyone like
it. Yeah. In a different form.
If you go in South also, without paisam.
Yeah, there's no meal proper.
Or without curd or without buttermilk.
Oh, absolutely.
They can't leave it.
Yes. But how is the number game here? Are you feeling the heat here? Because as I said, there are cooperatives, then there are local brands, then there are national brands, and there are MNCs into this market as well.
For different product, we have different competitions.
Sure.
Yeah, but the cow ghee, absolutely. We are the pioneer leader into the pan India. We compete with all regional players for the particular cow ghee. But pan India, no one have any brands. Recently, Patanjali has started.
Okay.
Yeah, they started and they promoted cow ghee, cow ghee, cow ghee. Yeah, and it's good for the create the market. Yeah, this type. When we introduce the goat cheese, when we speak about the goat cheese, we have so many SKUs. Around 64 varieties and cheese flavors and SKUs. But for the competitors, they are into the 2, 3, 4, 5 varieties. Yeah, they are in there just like a processed cheese block and slice, that's it. But when we introduce this type of the cheese, there is no competition such a for the cheese. And cheese is a really very highly growth. Yeah, highly growth, growing market, as well as consumer and as good as institute also.
Sure.
Yeah,
sure.
All food chain, international food chain, they are coming and they are growing very fastly. There is a recently study, the every food chain, even local pani puri wala to from McDonald's.
Yes.
They all growing by 20 to 22%.
So how is the dairy market growing? What is the per annum growth that you see in this space?
Yeah, per annum we are saying the 15% growth.
Okay.
For us. Yeah, into the country-wise, it's 8 to 10%.
All right.
But we are growing by...
higher than what the country is. Okay. Well, with that, let's take a very short break. When we come back, we'll talk more about the dairy markets and, of course, much on the road forward.
CNBC-TV18 Weekender. Only on CNBC-TV18.